Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video, I'll be showing you that how you can implement the favorite button in the Android app recyclerview. Fine, so you can see that guys, these two questions are now successfully, I mean, they are related. So when I will click on it and I will open this related activity. And here guys, you can see that two questions, where is NASA and how to increase immunity. Fine, and if I will go back and then guys, if I will check this one also, so after this I will have three questions. So you can see that when I will open this related activity, so you can see that now we have these three questions. And guys, after this, if you think that you want to remove it, so you can simply click on this one, two. Now we will only have one question, what is Firebase. So when I will open it again, so here you can see that we will have only one question. So you can see that the functionality is working absolutely fine. So today in this tutorial, I'm going to show you that how you can implement this. And guys, you know, its first part is already out. Its link is showing on the top. You can go and watch that video first and then come on this video, because it will be very helpful for you. So guys, without wasting time, let's start. So guys, you can see that I have already created this item.xml file. You can see that it is a related underscore item.xml file, and I have already created it. For saving time, you can create it, nothing is special. You can see the only difference here is this view reply text view. Fine, and otherwise everything is same. Fine, as this question item.xml, so you can copy the code, you can change their IDs. Fine, so after creating it guys, let me show you the codes. You can see this is a card view, then linear layout, and guys, everything is same, just like this one question.xml file. Understand? So after this, you have to come here in the viewholder.java, and guys, here we are already doing these things. So what you have to do is simply copy this method, control plus C. Fine, and go after this favorite checker and paste it. Fine, this time we will create set item related, so you have to change the name, that's all you have to do. Fine guys, and then after this, simply delete this codes from here, because we have to declare some more. So simply write text view, and text view for time TV, and simply write time TV equals to item view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot, and time related question TV. You can see the ID is easily visible. Fine, and then after this, for image view, simply write item view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot image view IV, or you can write related IV question item. Fine, so you can easily understand that it is the ID of image view. So you can see that this is for related, this is image view, this is question, this is item. So in this, by giving the IDs in that way, you can easily understand it. Fine, so that's why I'm doing this name TV. Oops, so that is the easy way for doing it. Simply write item view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot name related name question TV. You can understand, and then after this, again text view, that is going to be question TV. Fine, then equals to item view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot question related question item TV. Fine, and then after this, what is left? I mean, we have let me check that 1, 2, 3, 4 text view and one image view. So one more text view, time, name, question, and yeah, text view for reply. So simply write reply btn equals to item view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot reply related reply item queue. Understand? After this, here you have to write is Picasso dot get dot load. So we have to load the URI, sorry, we have to load the URL, the dot into image view. Fine, and then here you have to write name TV dot set text, that is going to be name. Fine, so guys, these things are not very complex. If you are following my tutorials, so you can easily do this. Fine, that is an easy thing, so don't be panic, just follow my steps and everything will work. Fine, so after this, here you have to write question and then reply button has nothing to do with it. So yeah, now almost done. So guys, after this we can move here in the activity, I mean Java class, related this is related class, fine. So here we have to declare some variables for Java class. So first of all guys, we need variable for recyclerview. So let me open the related here we need the related activity. Yes, so go here in the split and guys here let me simply write linear layout and then a very basic text view with match parent, height wrap content, and text is going to be related list, fine. And text color is going to be color red, text size 20 sp, text style bold, fine. Then simply close it and text alignment should be center, that's fine. And a little bit of padding will make it beautiful. Yes, so after this guys, here you have to write the orientation that is going to be vertical obviously. And then guys, after this here you just need a very basic recycler view. So it's just a basic recycler view with match parent, height match parent, everything is match parent. And then we will give margin that is going to be 4 or 3 dp, that is just little bit. And then id that is going to be rv underscore related, then close it, done. So after this guys, now we can go here in this Java class and we need to declare variables for recyclerview, then recyclerview, and then firebase database, and database equals to firebase database dot get instance, fine. And after this you have to write database reference and then reference so we can retrieve the data from real-time database. So fine guys, fine. So simply write to recyclerview equals to find view by id r dot id dot rv related, then few more lines. After this you have to write is recyclerview dot set has fixed sized, and that is going to be true, fine guys. And then after this you have to write recyclerview dot set layout manager, and we will pass new. So we are initializing the layout, so layout manager, and then you have to pass this, fine. Now we are done with this recycler view. So after this you here you have to write is reference, and that is going to be equals to database, firebase database. And then guys here you have to open this fragment 2, fine. And guys here you can see that this is a reference for the favorite list, so simply copy it from here, this is all we need. And then guys here you have to simply paste it, fine, and simply remove this favorite list reference to this reference. And we need the current user ID, so you can simply copy the codes from here. I think we must have the codes, control plus C, then come back here in this related Java and then simply paste it. So guys, now you can see that we have this reference, now we can easily proceed, done. After this guys, all you need to write here is we can copy the codes from this fragment 2 again. So that is why I like this thing, because we can copy the codes always, fine. So we have to copy these codes and till this recycler view, and then simply come here and then simply paste it, fine. So after this guys, just go in the beginning, and here you have to change this database reference to reference, fine. Now the error is done, otherwise everything is same, question member, and it is also the view holder class, no needs you have to change. But this is an activity, so you have to go here in this and fragment activity. So instead of this here you have to write is application, yeah, because this is a application, I mean this is activity, so you have to write application. And here you have to write get application, and I hope there should be no error. Fragment activity to application, I have changed it and it is showing the error. So guys, what here you have to do is you have to change this set item to set item related, error is gone. See, the error is gone. Fine. And then guys, after this here I will remove this codes because this is not required for us. So let me delete it on cancelled. I think I should delete this one too. Yeah, now it's fine. So guys, after this you have to change here is this item related. So here you have to write is related item. Fine. And otherwise everything is correct, I think. So yeah, so it is correct. So guys, these are the strings that we are retrieving. So now we don't need it, but we may need it in future tutorials. So I will not remove this code. Fine. I will just simply comment it. Fine. Simply comment it. Yeah, that's fine. So guys, after this it's time to run the app, I think. And so guys, you can see that the app is working absolutely fine. There is no error. And guys, now when you will open this fragment 2, so we can see our questions, all the questions that we have asked in our previous tutorials. So as you can see that the questions are now loaded successfully. And guys, you can see that we have these two questions in the favorites item. So when I will click on it, so it will open the bottom sheet. And when I will click on this related, so it should show us these two questions. You can see that this is where is NASA, how to increase immunity at home. Fine. And guys, when I will click on back button, so we will come here and you can see that where is NASA and how to increase immunity. And if I will uncheck this one question, so now it is not in the favorites. So now when I will open it, so it will only show where is NASA. Fine. And when I clicked on it, so you will only see where is NASA. You can see that the question is removed. And again guys, when I will check these three, all of them, and when I will open the related activity, so I will see all three questions. You can see that the three questions, and when you will click on these three questions, so you can see the answer of these questions. Fine. We will implement that functionality just in upcoming tutorials. So guys, I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. And guys, one more thing that you have to keep it in mind is that I'm giving you a task that guys, just like this favorite questions, you have to retrieve the questions in this your questions activity. Fine. The procedure will be same, item.xml, and all the codes will be same, but the reference will be the, you know, what is the reference here is in the ask activity. Let me show you. I will give you some hint. Fine. So here guys, you have to retrieve the questions of this reference. Fine. You can see that this is user questions reference. You have to retrieve the questions in that activity. I think that is not a complex thing. You all can do this if you are following my tutorial. So guys, in next tutorial I hope you will do this by yourself, because I will show you, then after this I will implement the reply functionality, and I will not show you how you can retrieve questions in your questions activity, because that is a very similar part, and it is, I think you guys should be, you guys should be able to do this. So that's why I will not implement it. You have to do this by your own. So I hope you like my tutorial. Please like this video, subscribe my channel guys. If my tutorials are helping you, then please subscribe my channel. And if you want to donate, you can donate some money. Fine. And that will be very helpful for me. And guys, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Thank you for watching.